Right.
And we didn't want to just be two pieces of bread, right? So we decided to become Texas Toast, and we wore like a little hat, like a cowboy hat, a sheriff pin, a little like bandana.
Wait, that's hilarious. See, that's my, like, this day and age, older, like, that's funny. Like, last Halloween, I was, I'm gonna let you finish, but last Halloween, I was the school bus that hit Regina George.
That was like,
yeah, so like I got a whole entire like school bus outfit, and I got like a blonde wig, and I like taped it to the front, and I put a little blood. Yeah.
That was a big brain moment.
Yeah, well, so was the Texas Toast.
I really don't think that was my idea. I don't want to take credit. I think that was her idea.
Okay, but it's still like it's not like you saw it on a TV show.
No. She came up with it.
It's original.
My idea with the Texas Toast costume, which can show you how my brain works, is I told us that we were gonna do the polar, like I signed us up to do the polar plunge in the Texas Toast costumes because it was going to get us into the newspaper, and that was a big deal.
And you couldn't move your arms or legs in these costumes.
They were foam too. So we jumped into the lake in the foam costume that which acted like a sponge and absorbed, not freezing, literally freezing cold. This was like in December in Wisconsin, and it absorbed all the water. There was like six men that came up and had to like curl us out of the water, and then had to like rip it off of us because it got so heavy.
All I can think about is how you're exaggerating each other, because she said it was December, everybody, but it was her Halloween costume. She exaggerates.
No. I made us wear it again.
Oh.
I said, well, because we wanted to, they had a contest. We could have dressed up. Everyone was in different costumes. People could vote on whoever had the best costume, but you voted with like money, I believe. So it was like donating. So whoever got the most money for how good their costume is when they jumped in got to be the newspaper.
Did you make it?
Yeah.
See, no, that was good. See, I can't make a second in my school bus costume. But like that's fine. Like one year, like my brother was a banana tree. Like he dressed up as a tree on banana tree.
That is so niche.
Like it's like I love niche costumes.
Yes, that is, I like that. Centrum. So, I think it's time for us to have a little bit of fun. How are we going to do that? I keep thinking I have to sing the segment intros in like different voices. So here's one today. I'm going to sing it in chicken voice. And so, Halloween edition.
Okay.
That's what a big chicken sounds like. So, for the night.
No, that was good.
So, these are stories from Reddit thread. Am I an asshole? I do know that there is a podcast where girls say, like, am I the asshole? And they're reading these crazy stories. I don't know if this is from a specific thread or what this is from. Give us ideas. If there's any other way that we can word am I the asshole for these, let us know. Because I love reading these. It's so fun. I love judging.
Okay.
In a respectful way. Right. You know? Are you ready?
Yeah.
This is a hefty paragraph. Stay with me here. I live in a large neighborhood, about 90 houses. We are what's considered the rich neighborhood.
Okay.
So our neighborhood has always been a hotspot for trick-or-treaters. Guilty. I always would look up where like the expensive houses were, like where all the doctors lived.
Oh yeah.
So
oh
the
yeah.
Full-size candy bars.
Yeah, there's an area in my town where we would always go.
Like watch me, this is the city that I grew up in. We used to get about 70 to 1,000 kids a year.
That's a lot. That's quite the range.
It says 700 to 1,000.
Oh,
I'm so sorry. 700 to 1,000 kids a year.
Oh, I haven't seen Halloween like this in years.
With this many people on the streets?
Yeah, it's kind of like
the drives now.
It's kind of like a ghost town lately.
That was really Mario to you. That was really cringy.
I thought that was a good joke.
I've always loved getting trick-or-treaters because my kids are teens now and they don't trick-or-treat anymore. But in the last 4 years, it's gotten ridiculous. There's thousands of kids and their parents flooding the streets, people with hay in their rigs carrying their kids around, trampling yards, littering candy wrappers everywhere, and the amount of small children walking around by themselves is appalling.
This is honestly bizarre to me because something that's like really upset me like in the recent years is the fact that I feel like no one, especially with like the social media age, I feel like no one is out on Halloween anymore, and often it's like just deserted. Like,
is it trick-or-treating a thing anymore?
No, it really, sometimes like I will drive around on Halloween and not even realize it's Halloween until like 4 p.m. So like where is this town?
Is that because of COVID though?
No, even before that. I'd say like the past like 5 years.
Really?
Yeah.
I think where I grew up, there isn't a lot going on. So when trick or treat comes around, you don't miss it.
Okay.
Like, that is the event of the century.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And they have certain hours that it goes till it doesn't start with them. And people will just get tired of sitting out, so just leave everything out on the porches. Or maybe they have the trick or treating like at events instead of walking around the neighborhood, because how are you supposed to walk around?
Right.
Miles and miles and miles.
Yeah.
And miles of places. People from the neighboring town of 30,000 take their kids to my neighborhood. I was annoyed, but I never really did anything about it until 2 years ago.